You're now at the lab with Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory. My name is Sam Diamond, and this week at the lab, the time of our lives. Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it. In case you're unfamiliar, that's the famous 20th century philosopher slash fictional high school student, Ferris Bueller.
Bueller.
Ferris is an expert in stopping to look around at life in action. Here at Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, developmental biologists are interested in looking at life at its earliest and most fundamental stages. Here's CSHL Professor Christopher Hammell.
Genes are controlled by a set of machinery, and you turn genes on and off. And for developmental biologists, we're interested in figuring out basically how that sets up the body plan of the organism. One of the things that's been underappreciated in developmental biology is how timing becomes important for that. So it really is an intuitive problem. You wouldn't start making fingernails on an arm until you had started to make the arm.
To get to the bottom of this problem, Hammell is looking closely at a kind of worm known as C. elegans. These worms are the perfect test subjects to study the timing of development because, one, they only live for about 20 days, and two, they're see-through. Hammell and his collaborators came up with a new imaging technique to capture gene expression as it occurs inside C. elegans. They identified a quartet of molecules that time the animal's growth stages with a concerto-like precision.
This clock we've discovered sets up the cadence of that song of development. It's a coordinator of the orchestra. It controls when the trombone goes, how loud it gets, and how long the note lasts.
This is the first time that gene expression has ever been captured in real time throughout an animal. But perhaps even more incredible, the mechanism that times C. elegans' development works a little bit like circadian clocks. You know, the thing we plan our days around. There's still a lot of work to be done before we can figure out how our developmental clocks enable us to become complex characters like Ferris Bueller or his best friend Cameron Fry. But you can rest assured, our scientists aren't letting the mysteries of life pass us by. We're looking at them up close every day. Thanks for listening to At the Lab. Please be sure to subscribe wherever you get your podcasts. And visit us at cshl.edu for more fascinating stories like this one. For Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, I'm Sam Diamond, and I'll see you next time at the lab.